You have Rick Porcello going to the New York
Mets. I like that.
They got Michael Wacha, incentive-based deal, $3 million, but in case he needs to start, that can get bumped up to around $10 million. What do you think of what the Mets are doing?
I'd like to throw that question at Dan O'Dowd.
I have been called a lot of things. I'm okay with that.
Because I thought once they signed Wacha, I had heard whispers that they were going after Rick Porcello. Yeah. And then once I saw Wacha sign with the incentive-laden deal, I thought that meant Rick was out.
Sure.
Both these guys got to touch the ball.
Yeah, Wacha's, though, if you look at his career splits, he's had some success out of the pen. You know, guys, you know, when's the last time you've gone through a season with five starters? The Mets have no depth in the upper part of their organization from a starting pitching standpoint, except for the David Peterson kid. So they're just trying to add depth.
And you would take probably one of those guys from the bullpen and try and start him.
I probably would. But, you know, in this case, their bullpen probably needs to be put into a position where it can be as successful because it wasn't good last year.
Can Rick Porcello bounce back and be?
No doubt. I think, absolutely. You know, here's, I told Cliffy before the show, I think the analytics got this guy.
Yeah.
You know, I think he got caught between what kind of pitcher he was, and he kind of lost everything that he was. I also think there was a residual effect of postseason from the year before. Think about how many times he took the ball on short rest in high-pressure situations out of the pen. So I think it was a combination of a lot of things. I think this guy's a great athlete. He's got a tremendous feel for his delivery. I think he's a good bounce-back candidate.
I think he has to get back to that delivery that made him, you know, one of the best in the league. And, you know, to just, when you lose that one pitch, he had a two-seamer that was really good. And it was his out pitch. He could use it when he needed it in the count to get to two strikes. And then he lost the feel. And then the ball became fat for him, right? Right down the middle. And I think, you know, he started to think a little bit more. So I think he has to not try to get back to the two-seamer, but more so eliminate it and then figure out how to pitch without it and be effective, because I really believe he can do that.
He's pitched in every big ball game. There's nothing in this game he hasn't seen. He's been to the big leagues at 19 on a veteran-laden team with Jim Leland as his manager, probably beating the tar out of him to get better.
Mm-hmm.
He was around the best in the games, the Verlanders, the Scherzers of the world, goes over to Boston, wins the Cy Young.
Yeah, I also think maturity-wise, he has a chance to help Noah Syndergaard.
Yeah.
Because when you talk to Rick Porcello about his job, and his job's, I take the ball every fifth day, and I give my team a chance to win no matter how I'm feeling, that's a good mentality to try to add to that starting rotation.
Yeah. I think Brody needs a good winter meetings. Because last year, I love Brody, great guy. But you can make the argument that the Cano and Edwin Diaz trade, the reason why they didn't go to the playoffs. Diaz, ERA over 5, blew a ton of games. Robbie Cano wasn't Robbie Cano, what he thought he was getting. That deal held the Mets back from being in the postseason.
Man, they looked good at the time, though.
Right, but he needs these moves this year. This offseason to pan out.
Yeah. You know what move I like? I like the Mariznick steal, too.
I do. I will argue, though, that he needs that move from last year to work out this year.
Yeah, well, you can't get rid of it.